Hey there, it's Robin, and welcome to the third installment of my series. If you haven't already, make sure to check out the playlist linked above for more episodes. I promise you won't want to miss them. This time around, we want to dive into something I'm sure many of us have encountered, that dreaded error message when exporting a project.
Uh-oh.
Look familiar? Or perhaps you've found yourself wondering about compound clips, retime clips, or which clips have a specific role assigned to them in your project timeline. Well, you're in luck because in this video, I'm going to show you the advanced timeline search in Final Cut Pro that will not only save you time, but also spare you the frustration of hunting through your project manually. Let's take a look. So, I don't know how many of you already knew this, but for as long as I can remember, you could already simply enter missing as the search term in your event search field, for example. And any missing media was filtered and listed. After that, you just relinked the media as needed. In fact, you could and still can enter a couple of things such as audition, compound, multicam, or synchronized. And any of those media types were also filtered whether the search term appeared in the name or not. And that was pretty much it. But maybe you had a fairly complex timeline such as this, and when trying to export it, we're told that your project has missing or offline titles, effects, generators, or media. And even if you had disabled a missing effect, etc., so technically you had nothing to worry about, the error would still appear. Or maybe you were wondering what that little exclamation mark on your event is all about, even though you couldn't see any missing media. And while you could do the same in the project timeline by either clicking the index button or simply hitting Command F when the timeline was active to open the index window, and do the same here with missing, compound, etc., until now there was little more you could do beyond that. What about missing effects, for example? Well, as of 10.8, the list of searchable criteria has grown considerably. As anyone who has watched my video on Final Cut's duplicate ranges will know, there is a pop-up menu next to the magnifying glass in the index's search field. Clicking on it now reveals not only the ability to filter by duplicate ranges as before, but there are now 5 additional options, which I'd say are all pretty self-explanatory. I can now select missing media to have any missing media in this project listed, or if I select missing effects, I get a list of any clips that have either a missing video or audio effect or both. And as we can see, it even lists any missing transitions you might have, something that until now was even harder to figure out than general effects with complex timelines such as this, since they aren't visible by just looking at the timeline. Selecting video effects or audio effects displays a chronological list of the clips that match those characteristics. Last but not least, my personal favorite, retiming, because I honestly have always been a little annoyed at the fact that there was never an easy way to figure out if and where I had retimed any clips in a project. And even if I knew that I had, I would have to tediously go through the entire timeline or select everything and hit Command R to reveal any retiming I or someone else had done. Something you might also want to know if passing your project over to another app that doesn't understand or recognize retime clips, for example. This full reveal obviously being somewhat messy and inefficient, since even this way I can't be sure that I'm not missing maybe just a small retimed section of a clip somewhere. But now I simply select retiming from the list and all retimed clips are listed. With that, I can either select them individually or even hit Command A to select them all and press Command R to only reveal the retime editor for those clips that have actually been retimed. Super helpful. By the way, you don't even have to choose the desired search criteria from the menu. You can simply enter the term or just part of the term manually if you prefer. Enter retim or retime clips, or maybe video E for any clips with video effects applied. And if you enter miss, you get all categories of missing. So in this case, both missing media as well as missing effects. That's obviously assuming none of the media names contain any of these search terms. Oh, and not to forget, if you've added metadata such as reel, scene, camera angle, or any such information to media in your timeline, that too can now be searched. Pretty cool and super useful if you ask me. And one last small addition to the search option concerns the event and smart collections filtering options. If you hit Command F with the event window active, you, as always, get the filter window where, by default, you can enter a text-based search term. And starting with version 10.8, there are two additional search criteria for searching text. Now, next to the inclusion, exclusion, and is not options, we have additional starts with and ends with filters. So there you have it. Do you see yourself as someone who will benefit from these new options? Like I know I will? Let us know down in the comments. I hope you found value in what you saw, and if you enjoyed the video and learned something new, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Speaking of more content, stay tuned for the next video where we'll explore the improved FX controls, or maybe check out the previous video on the machine learning enhanced smooth slow-mo. Thanks for watching, thanks for your support, and I'll see you next time. Take care.